Hey guys, what is up? It is Dylan. Welcome back to a brand new video. So we are back on Vectary. I guess I could show you how to make a. We'll do a hat just for starting. So now, of course, you guys might think it's easier to use a sphere for the cap part of the hat, but it is easier to use a box. So just like I showed you in the last video, just grab a box. You maybe if you want to like center it better, you'll it doesn't really matter because you can still move it with scale. But you know, just I'd start over here somewhere in this square, maybe right here. So you want to click, you want to go there and there. So now that's sort of your, I don't know, I guess that's kind of your square to start out with. So this is how you kind of make a hat. So follow along. There's your kind of basic thing. So you want to go to select faces, you want to go underneath and you want to hit backspace. So now it looks like an upside down open box. Then what you want to do after that is you want to turn on smoothing. There we go. So now it kind of looks like a it looks like remember yesterday when I had the whole thing and I had it and I said it looked like a demented hat. Well, it's the exact same thing, just flipped upside down. So, you're gonna do the exact same thing as I said yesterday. So, select faces, selections, jog, which is kind of like a select all, and then you just like, yep. And then you hit extrude or E, and that'll add in random blue arrow. Any of them you can actually select, and it'll add the thickness. So, then you just wanna make your cap. Then you'll have a. I mean, this isn't. If you printed this, it would probably be a functioning hat. But like when I make the beak, it's gonna be right here, so you might have to cut that. Or this measuring isn't full. I mean, right now it's on millimeters. If I go here and you go to your, I mean, there's so many things here, but you know, like yeah, it's pretty cool. Units, so measurement, like this is millimeters, inches, so it's kind of stuck on millimeters. I mean, inches are kind of, I don't know, but I haven't really played around with it like that much. I haven't really printed anything yet, but I was thinking of it. So yes, that is like that, and there's your kind of cap. Now if you want to have a different colored hat, so I to be honest, I could make this. Actually, let's put it on there. All right. Now I can make. I'm gonna make this a hat that I had just recently ordered online. That looks pretty cool. I'm gonna make that like that. I'm gonna add steel to make it shinier, cause that's cool, right? I'll actually have to show you some of the hats I did later on after we're done this. So now you have kind of a shiny disco looking hat. So now you need the beak, of course, because you know this could just be a random army hat what it looks like. So now for the beak, you're gonna want to draw a box. Now you're gonna want to try to eyeball this. Go about right here. Nah, maybe back a little bit more. All right, I think I on there we go. All right, redo that. So you want to go about right here, because when you smooth it, it's going to be smaller anyways. Go right about there. Then you want to make it, so for the height, you want to make it like the lowest that you can make it, but a little bit higher, so that way it's not a, like just not anything, you know what I mean? So now we have this, now that's kind of your hat, but we're not done yet, so you want to select the face. Of your beak. Oh, I actually forgot to add a layer. So this is if you want the same color of a hat. But so we'll actually delete that. So we'll just go undo because you know that's the magic button that we all love. Go forward. And yeah, so there's the beanie again. Now this is layer one. So if I wanted to, I could take that away. It'll still show up. If I go back, there you go, right? So don't think that you delete it if you do that. It's just still there. So now we're gonna go to layer two. So now when you're on layer two, it acts as if is like this is a part of the whole thing. So like It's kind of weird, but it doesn't, it's not, it's really cool actually. So now that way it doesn't connect, and then you can add different colors, so we don't have to have the same colors. I'm gonna do it about right here. All right, there. So now you have this looking thing. It obviously looks kind of bad, so then you have to turn it into looking good. Turn on smoothing, there is your hat, but of course we're not done. Hit the space bar, add it to the yep, and then you're gonna add, you know what, we're gonna make it black this time. Yeah, dark black. Yeah, all right, and we're gonna make it steel, and we're gonna make it 3D print. So I ordered a white and black hat recently. Steel, if I wanted to turn off steel, it might look a little bit better than, like, it doesn't look the exact same, but it doesn't matter. You guys can do it however you want. I'm not trying to say what kind of color you have to choose, because that would just be me being a jerk. So here you go. So yeah, you kind of just want to play around with all of the arrows. I don't know exactly what every single one does. I know how they can move them around. I haven't studied them enough, but you just want to play around with them until you get the right beak. So we'll have this scale, and you just totally play around with it. It's just a nice little fun thing to do once in a while. Let's get on this amazing program. I know we don't want to do that. That one moves it. Let's check it out. I think that's about pretty good. But if you look in here, let me zoom in here. Now, if you look in here, see how the hat, it there's like a thing here. Now, I'm pretty sure there is a way to cut that. You'll see this tiny, tiny line here. That didn't work like I wanted it to, but that's okay. Cause with like, if you print this right now, you can actually like cut this with something, and I feel like that'd be better. Whoa, what am I doing? I don't know what that was. Oh no, that was one of the rotates. All right, there. So yeah, that there's your hat. If you want to change it with colors, keep the same layer to same color. So that's kind of the whole hat. There's another one that you can do actually. So we're gonna delete these layers and create a new one. So here's another hat that you could do. It's kind of the same thing, a little bit more basic. So this one we're gonna make like that. Height will be about the same as last time. There you go. Go to the bottom. Oh, that's a little bit longer than I wanted. All right, we'll redo this. All right, right here. Let's make sure our length is good. All right, there we go. So there you go, and there's your square. Go to the bottom, click the bottom face, and delete. Then you're gonna go to smoothing. Then you're gonna go, obviously, to selections, jog, extrude, make it thicker. Or not thicker, but just take away like the extra bit that was there. So there's your kind of, this is a toque, by the way, like a winter toque. So there's kind of your bottom. So I guess we can make it a little bit thicker, because why not? Just a little bit, because they are pretty thick. Oh yeah, there we go, that's nice. All right, so now we're gonna switch it to textured, and then we'll let's make this hat a nice blue. All right, actually, let's make it look like a real toque. I mean, come on, 3D print. Yeah, that looks like a toque. So there you go, there's that. So now for the toque, for the ball part of the toque, you're gonna want to look directly down on the shape, and you're gonna want to add a sphere to about whatever the middle is. About the middle, you're just gonna that's a little bit off. All right, that's nice. Actually, what, hold on, let me fix this. All right, peoples, sorry, it kind of like messed up, so now I had to redo the half heart, but here we are. So now, oops, sphere, you're gonna want to go to the middle, The ball is gonna be necessarily big. I mean, it is supposed to be big, so there's your toque. Not exactly center, but you can change that just like this. No. Hold on. You have to kind of select this. I should have done this on a separate layer, actually. So let's just delete that, and then I'll add an extra layer. And then we'll add the ball on top. All right. It's not centered, but we can always do that. Like this. The little white dot in the middle is always good for moving, like if you want to move it. All right, so there we go. Now we're gonna make it a different color. We're gonna make this one. We're gonna make it a shiny top. And we're gonna make it. Let's make it a nice red, shall we? Looks like a hat from the cops or something. All right, that's cool. There's your toque. Now I know this is 3D print. It is not the kind of texture that toque should be made out of, but it still looks like it, so I'll take it. So there you go. That's kind of the toque, and now we'll just move on to something else. All right, guys. So once you kind of have a blank thing, there is a thing over here. It's called Add Plugin. Now it's gonna pull up this, and it's gonna have different things. So you can add kind of different things. So like mirroring, we'll put a mirror right in the front, so whatever you do to the left side will appear on the right. You can add a tire. You can add. There's lots of cool things. I've the only ones I've really tried. I've tried the tire one and the mirroring. I haven't really played around with these ones yet, but I will. Then they have the text icons. They got a bunch of stuff. You can even search for plugins. But yeah, so that's kind of cool. That's another cool feature that they have. You can duplicate layers. So let's say I want to have two hats. I duplicate, I delete, and yeah, you can just pull this up and down the menu if it gets in the way. It's kind of cool. Help center. I was playing around with it. I already went through these, like I said last time, and I was seeing if they had step by step on some of these, but I haven't really been checking it out. I feel like I'm gonna take a stab at that in a little bit. So yeah, there's fit to view. Like if you've taken the tutorial, you would know. Now I'm just gonna draw. So this is, let's say I want to make I'm into hockey. I'm a hockey player. So let's say I wanted to make a hockey stick. This is just gonna be like a rough sketch. So to make it easier on yourself, you're gonna want to come down here to snapping. You're gonna want to turn it on, and you're gonna want to snap to grid, snap to end, and snap face. Now, what's that like? What that is gonna do is it's kind of just gonna help you be accurate. So hold on, and then you're gonna want to go back to snapping. You're gonna want to take off snap to grid, and you're just gonna want to snap the end of the hockey stick. So you're gonna want to like go like this. Let's maybe make it like this. Just curl it around. Maybe add a little bit more right there. Add it to this square and end. Now, when you click select, it's going to turn into a shape, or maybe just a flat shape. So then you're going to want to select faces. You're going to want to extrude. You're gonna see this blue arrow. Pull it up. Now I don't want my hockey stick too thick. Originally, you could obviously, like, this is just like a model, right? So like if I wanted to, I could go through here. I could make the blade thinner. I can do whatever I want to this. But that's kind of for other tutorials to get deeper into more of the complex things. So I'm just trying to stay basic. So yeah, you can also draw your shapes. You don't have to just base it off of shapes that are already made. So it is very cool. You can actually hand draw. So let's say I wanted to make a circle, or that's kind of a messy circle for me. Now this is the only thing that sucks though. With this, see how there's it's not a full shape like that one, like it didn't appear pink. Well, I think that's because it didn't have its maybe it wasn't hold on. Yeah, see, it's actually, what if I try this? I haven't played around with this feature, the wheel on this part, so let's just make a D. Maybe if we try circle, oh, that just turns into a circle. Distance, let's just make it 5. Oh, so you can, all right, that's cool. So yeah, that's kind of a cool feature as well. So yeah, hand draw isn't the greatest thing if you want to make a shape as like this. So yeah, if you definitely want to make your own shape, use draw lines and play around with the snapping, see what you guys like, because there's a bunch of different things that people use. So we're just gonna make this a nice red beautiful hockey stick. All right, so yeah, that's a hockey stick. That's kind of it for this video, guys. So I will be doing a video again soon. So of course, like, this is an awesome program. I've actually I've kind of got stuck to this program. Like, I've noticed throughout classes and breaks, instead of actually play hockey first break at school, second break, I always play around with this and I just have fun. I love my 3D stuff, and Vectary is an awesome program. It's not basic, but it is very, very useful. And I mean, some programs are kind of hard and it takes a little bit to learn, so it's easy at a young age to start nice and small, short and sweet, whatever kind of thing you want to have on this. But so yeah, it's nice to just have this right there and easy tutorials. It's easy to build stuff. So it's an awesome program. I definitely recommend that you guys check it out if you haven't already. It is amazing, and like I've said, I've been stuck to it for almost 5 days now, and my teacher showed me how to, like, what Vectary was. Ever since you showed me, I've wanted to learn everything about it. So yeah, guys, please leave a like, please subscribe, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day or evening, wherever you guys, your time zones are. But please leave a like, of course, because likes are awesome. So yes, guys, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I really appreciate you guys checking this out if you already have. You do need a PC, but it is the best one of the best programs. So I mean, I wouldn't expect an awesome program like this to be on mobile devices. But yes, guys, make sure that you check this out. Make sure you check out Vectary. It is an awesome program. But yeah, guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, of course, smash the like button. Like I've said this, subscribe, and see you guys. Bye.
Bye. Have a beautiful time. Made that music. Can anybody out there hear me?